Previously on Guardians of the Galaxy.
You don't know a lot about me, but before I met you guys, there was someone. She's gone now, but maybe with that relic I can make her ungone.
I know you've got a lot on your mind, but that kid you fought, maybe he does too. Promise me in the future you'll use your words instead of your fists.
I will, Mom. I promise.
Thank you, baby.
The Eternity Forge resides here, pending such time as it can be wielded responsibly. Until then, she shall remain entombed across the galaxy.
Come find me, Peter. I'll be waiting for you. You're nearly there, Peter.
I got it, Mom.
Thanks, baby.
Another headache?
Just a little one. Stop worrying. It's fine. Just took me by surprise.
Didn't look like a little headache.
Nothing I can't handle. Especially with you looking out for me. I better get that prescription before the pharmacy closes. Stay out of trouble till I get back, okay? Be good. I know that's not always easy for you.
I'll be a perfect little angel, like always.
I better hurry back then. I'll be back soon.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, Mr. Pinkle.
Here to get that mixtape copied?
Yeah.
Sure is a nice thing to do for your mom. How's she doing, anyway?
Oh, she's not doing so well.
I'm sorry to hear that, Pete. Well, I'm sure this is going to make her feel a lot better. Music's got some powerful mojo. Both sides? Come back in about an hour, and it'll be ready.
Hey, Petey! You make that mix for your boyfriend?
I made it for your mom.
Watch it, or you'll be swallowing your own teeth. Afraid I'm gonna break it again?
You afraid I'm gonna hit you again?
Listen to you. Pretending you got balls. Hey, how's that lip doing? Give me that. What are you doing here anyway? You don't have money. Everyone in town's talking about it. Your mom can't even pay her medical bills. She's been going door to door asking for help like some pathetic loser. She's probably off looking for change in the sewers right now.
Screw you!
Aww. I heard Petey's put off feelings. You gonna go cry to mommy? Have her change your diapers? Because your daddy definitely can't. You gonna cry now? Huh? What are you gonna do about it?
You done yet? Elephant ears? You must get great reception with those things.
Nah, I'm not done. But your mom?
She sure is.
My dad goes drinking with her doctor. Told him everything. Guess she didn't feel like it was important enough to tell you. Oh, check it out. Dead woman walking. What's the point? Drugs ain't gonna help. My dad says you're gonna die anyway.
My mom's gonna be fine. She just needs the right medicine.
Get her some poison. At least then she won't be wasting money trying to get better.
Get out!
My dad's gonna...
Out!
You kept your promise. You didn't fight that jerk. I'm proud of you, Peter. Even though I didn't set a very good example. The things he said. I let my emotions get the better of me.
I'm sorry you heard that.
No, Peter. It's okay.
He said you were dying, Mom. Is that true?
Find me, please. You're so close, Peter.
What the? How did I get home?
Gamora!
Harder.
Hey. Are you okay? Because this temple is really messing with my head.
Hello, Gamora!
You can do better than that.
Not Nebula! It's me, Peter, who you like a whole lot and definitely do not want to kill!
Come on, this isn't fair! I don't have a sword!
Focus, Nebula. You need to be aware of everything around you. Perception's just as important as strength and speed.
None of them are important when I'm stuck here. I want to use what you've taught me somewhere outside of this room. I'm sick of just doing the same thing over and over, every single day.
You're not ready yet, Nebula. You still have a lot to learn.
Oh, really? Is that what you think? Looks like you've lost your touch.
Hardly.
That was actually a little impressive.
Just a little?
You're hurting me!
Ah!
father.
Nebula, you have grown so much.
Father.
You may yet be the greatest assassin in the galaxy. Don't you agree, Gamora?
I do. She's come a long way.
What a pleasant surprise. Perhaps being bested by your sister recalled the importance of humility. I have a mission for you. You will go to a Kree outpost on the planet of Phalion. There you will find General Tarval. He has come into possession of something I require, a device. Gamora, you will fetch the device for me. You, Nebula, you will kill the General.
Thank you, Father. I promise you, I will succeed.
I know you will, daughter. Gamora, you were always my favorite, but you have become cold, distant, forcing me to look to Nebula to tighten the slack, whether I believe she's capable or not.
I work better alone. I always have. Nebula doesn't need to be a part of this.
From what I witnessed, you could benefit from Nebula's assistance. I can no longer trust you on your own. Go and prepare. You will head out immediately. And Gamora, I know you no longer care. But if you fail, your sister will pay for your missteps. Tell Nebula I wish to speak with her.
Is everything all right? What's going on? I couldn't hear you, but Father, he didn't look happy.
I can't stand this place anymore. I can't stand him anymore.
Nebula! Come here!
I guess this is it. My chance to prove myself. Or fail miserably.
Don't worry, Nebula. I've got your back.
No. I've got to do this myself. It's what I've been training for. I won't let Father down. Let's just do this.
Nebula! Nebula! Nebula, are you all right? Are you hurt?
Why? Why did you do that?
What?
I had him. That was my kill and you took it from me! The father will be so upset with me.
You distracted him. I killed him. We did this together.
But father...
Thanos can complain about who did what all he wants. I don't care.
Father... Give me the device.
Nebula, what are you doing?
You took my kill. Give me the device in exchange. Give it to me! Now! I'm not asking here. Do it! Gamora, hand it over.
Fine. Here. Hey, it's going to be fine. We're going to be okay.
I was trying to snap you out of it before you killed me.
Well, that's not the way to do it.
Well, apparently it was. Stop. Stop slapping me. Stop it. Okay. Uncle.
Don't do that again. I don't know what happened. One minute you and I were walking into the temple, and the next
yeah,
I was...
Yeah, I know.
Wait, were you... Did you see all that? My memory?
Are you okay?
I've been trying not to think of that day. Because I really want to fix things with Nebula. But seeing that... She thought I was being selfish, taking away everything she worked so hard to achieve. That's why she turned on me, and why she'll never forgive what I did.
I saw what happened. You were just trying to protect her. You can't blame yourself for that.
I'm not so sure. That last moment, it became everything. All I remembered of her. There were times we were happy, despite Thanos, despite everything. We had each other. Maybe I could have done more. Been more honest with how I was feeling. Stopped just seeing her as someone I needed to protect.
I know you, Gamora. And I know you tried your absolute best to protect her. Nebula can't see that, then that's her problem, not yours.
Is it? Nebula is who she is because of me. That hatred, that coldness, her inability to trust anyone. She is Thanos' daughter. Who else could she be after I betrayed her? I failed her.
Listen to me. You didn't fail her. You don't fail at anything. You are the strongest person I know, okay? And I respect the hell out of you for that. And I don't just mean the ass kicking. I mean, believe me, you kick some serious ass.
I do kick a lot of ass, huh?
Hell yeah, you do.
Come on. Let's figure out why the Forge brought us here before things get even more... weird. Oh, man. My mom loved this song. She played that record non-stop.
Peter, wait. This place... it seems to be using our memories against us. We don't know what we'll find inside, or why it's been drawing us here.
Yeah, well, if anything goes wrong, you'll be here to protect me, right? You're not saying anything, and it's super worrying. Gamora, seriously?
Do you recognize this place?
Yeah. This is where my mom... this is where I saw her last.
I don't know what all this means, Peter. But I hope, somehow, you get your mom back.
Thanks. For understanding.
She's your family. Your real family. I know how much she means to you.
Are you?
You have known me for a while now. I am called Mantis.
Not your mom, right?
Definitely not.
You came for me. After all these... Ooh, what are these? They are very shiny.
Hey, over here.
Peter Quill. You're really here. It's been centuries. No, millennia. You were the first.
I came here expecting to find my mom.
I can explain.
Nice reflexes.
Let me try that again. May I borrow that? Your gun. It will only be for a moment.
Yeah, sure.
What?
I have another one.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It is so wonderful to be free of that tomb. No longer trapped in my own mind. Alone. You are truly the hero the legends foretold. So brave and handsome. Though perhaps not in the classical sense.
What?
Ha! You must have many questions for me.
I crossed the entire galaxy because my mom was calling to me, asking me to come find her. Where is she?
She is dead. But your mother, Meredith, she is alive in your memory.
Yeah, that doesn't explain anything.
I have been waiting for you all this time. The moment you touched the forge, I knew you were the Celestial One, that you could free me. So I reached out to you the only way I could, through your memories. The ones most vivid to you. But you must understand, I had no control over them. I was only trying to communicate. Oh no, that is not what I wanted at all. I am so sorry. I truly did not know you'd feel so violated. I'd hoped you would feel glad to see her again. I did not mean for my abilities to hurt you.
How?
Your mind is clouded with so many emotions, so you seek answers. But those answers will not help you.
How could you possibly know how he feels?
I can show you, angry lady. Oh, no. Never mind. May I show you? Please, I mean no harm. Watch. Peter Quill is filled with worry about you. He likes when you hit people. Is that right?
Do it again! Do it again! Come on!
With great pleasure.
Oh, this isn't going to go well.
Sorry. Inside joke. You wouldn't get it.
Oh, boy.
You see, I am an empath. I can read the emotions of others. It is my duty to help the Celestial One decide the fate of the Forge.
That could really come in handy.
Oh, she's gotta meet the rest of the group.
Yeah, introduce an emotionally charged being to a group who are emotionally sensitive. Who should we try on first?
I got just the one.
Something's supposed to be happening here?
This furry little creature is unfathomably sad.
Hey!
Now he is scared and angry.
Hey, cut it out! What is this, Quill? What's the bug lady doing to me?
Mantis is an empath, Rocket. She can sense your emotions. She's also the one who made us relive our memories.
That was you? We went halfway across the galaxy, got chased by that psycho Hala for a party trick?
It is my job to guide the Celestial One.
What the hell does that mean?
The Celestial One?
You messed with our minds. Why?
I am Groot.
She thinks I'm someone called the Celestial One. How about that?
Celestial what?
Why is there only one? And could that one also be me?
Oh, I can explain. Long ago...
Wait. Are you gonna spew some long mumbo-jumbo about where you come from and why I should care?
Yes. Is that a problem?
Remember Thanos? Going on like, now that I got this, I'm gonna roll through the galaxy like a giant turd and blah, blah, blah. The answer is magic. It's always magic. And that is good enough for me.
Her story might be important.
Well, I, for one, want to hear it. All of it.
Then it's time for a nap.
Go ahead, Mantis. Enlighten us.
Of course, Peter Quill. I have communicated only through my feelings for years. It is nice to communicate with my mouth. Eons ago, the Eternity Forge coalesced into existence as a way to balance the life energy of the universe. To create, you must destroy. And to destroy, you must create. But such colossal power cannot be wielded lightly. So I was brought in to ensure that the Forge was only wielded by someone deserving, and to help guide the wielder down the right path. But I waited. And waited. Years went by. Many unworthy tried to use the Forge. Some even tried to force me to help them. The Kree decided that no culture had matured enough to use the Forge with the wisdom required. Eventually, the Forge and I were separated, locked away until a time when civilizations could reach the peak of wisdom and maturity. And that is only the beginning.
Well, thanks a lot for that, Pete.
What an interesting and relevant story. Aren't you glad we heard it all, champ?
Someday, Quill, I'm gonna blast you out an airlock.
I have not yet gotten to the most important part.
Kill me.
There is a legend of the Celestial One, the chosen one who shall arrive from the stars to use the Eternity Forge.
This Celestial One, what are they like?
Advanced intellect, emotionally mature, wise being capable of navigating the dark waters of immense power. Someone who can see beyond his own selfish desires to choose for the greater good.
That describes me pretty perfectly. Hey, come on, guys. Hey, knock it off.
It is not funny. Peter is the Celestial One.
Oh, you're so full of crap, lady. If Pete is this Celestial What's-It, then why didn't the stupid Forge work? Sure, it brought him back. But when we tried to use it again on someone else, it didn't do a damn thing.
Your loss. I can feel it has been with you for some time. The Forge is limited right now. It can only restore life to a body that is mostly whole and undeteriorated.
I am Groot.
That explains Hala's delightful corpse collection.
She'll bring them all back if she gets the Forge.
Fantastic! So it's incredibly useful to our worst enemy, but useless to us.
It can be made more useful.
How?
The Celestial One must deliver the Forge to the sacred shrine. There you can unlock its true power, or destroy it forever.
And that true power is what?
Returning anyone, from any time period, back to the realm of the living. Lost ones, loved ones, I suppose hated ones too, if you were so inclined, though I do not know why. That seems ill-advised, but it is Peter's decision to make.
Why would I destroy the Forge? This thing sounds awesome.
Hala!
It's
awesomeness comes with a price. Life energy cannot be made. It must be transferred.
So someone still has to die for the thing to work.
Then let's finish our drinks and go use this thing.
Yes!
Really? Who are you planning to kill?
Well, you're kind of annoying me right now.
Hala wants to use this forge to raise her army. We have to destroy
it. Not until my family is returned to me.
I am Groot.
Right? Groot says he's on my side. That's 3-1, Gamora. We win.
That is not true. Groot feels the opposite.
Maybe something got lost in translation. Hey, you try understanding I am Groot all the time. Those three words can mean anything. Don't look at me like that.
I can't believe I never thought to ask this question until now, and it's terrifying me. Do you even understand, Groot?
Of course I do. I'm sorry, I just don't want that thing destroyed until we use it. It was a one-time thing.
I am Groot.
Okay, a two-time thing.
So, it is a tie then.
Two for using it.
I am Groot.
I'm gonna take a guess. He said two for destroying it.
Don't you get what this means? We can bring back anyone that we lost.
At a cost.
No cost is too high.
Wow. Okay, this is, it's a lot to process here. Kind of heavy on the responsibility, you know? Let me think on it. Well, one way or another, this all ends at the shrine. Can you take us there, Mantis?
I have never been, but with your help, I believe I can sense its location. May we have some space to concentrate?
Gladly. If anyone needs me, I'll be emotionally unavailable.
And that's new.
Ha ha ha.
So, am I doing this right, or...?
It is easier if you don't talk.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah. I'm not, not talking.
I cannot sense the shrine. There is so much unrest among your crew. Their emotions are overwhelming me. They look to you for guidance. Help them.
Hey there, Groot. Oh. Is that a friend of yours?
I am Groot.
But I'll tell you this. We're all gonna be okay. No matter what happens with the Forge.
I am Groot.
Hey, bud. What's up?
Well, if it ain't Captain Indecision.
What are you?
I don't know what's holding you back from doing the right thing here, Quill. I mean, I can count on one paw how many folks ever get a chance to bring back someone they love.
I am Groot.
And what happens if Hala gets a hold of it, huh? This falls into the wrong hands, the whole galaxy is screwed.
The whole galaxy is already screwed. It's always screwed. You think if we destroy this thing, that'll make a difference? Ah, the only ones you're screwing are your so-called friends.
Rocket.
You know what, Pete? I wish the Forge had never brought you back. Yeah.
I am Groot.
It should have brought someone else. Anyone else back instead. Better than your worthless hide.
You don't mean that, Rocket.
Now you're telling me what I don't mean. Man the ego on you. I meant every damn word.
I am Groot.
Have a nice night.
Well, that's one way to clear his emotional unrest.
I am Groot.
Drax, how are you doing?
I was angry that you did not allow me to guard Nebula.
But that...
But now, I am hopeful. The Forge can bring my family back, if you choose to use it.
Well, I...
So I must trust you would not take away my chance to reunite with my wife and daughter. Even though you did not behave in a trustworthy manner.
Huh?
You used that antenna woman's powers without permission. It was wrong of you to do that. Rocket was clearly angered by what that woman said about his emotions.
Come on, it wasn't that bad. Was it?
Our feelings are our own. They belong to us alone.
Yeah, I probably shouldn't have done it. I'm sorry, bad taste on my part.
I am glad you are so apologetic. Though I do not understand how your mistake could taste badly. Her ability to see into our emotions, it must be difficult. I would not wish to know the pain of others as well as my own. Thank you for checking in on me, Peter. You may leave now.
Fine. 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 Fine.
Hey, are you okay? What the hell was that?
I tried to say everything I could think of. I thought maybe if I asked her to stick around for a while. Ugh. She won't hear it. Not from me. She'll barely even look at me.
So don't give up on her. Family is always worth it.
I know, I'm really trying. But I just can't find the right words with her. But maybe if we had more time, I could try talking to her again when she's calmed down. Give her some space without losing her altogether.
Well, they say time heals all wounds.
Who's they?
I have no idea.
Maybe I can get her to hang around. Just maybe not right now. Think she needs some alone time.
Hey, Nebula. Yeah, hey, it's me, Peter Quill, but you know that. You mind if I sit? Cool, yeah, this is really, how's the arm?
It's not bad. Would have come in handy to have both arms while fighting off the Kree. I suppose I'm lucky you let me out at all. So, thanks, I guess.
Oh man, you were awesome. And you only had one arm.
Well, yeah. Nice to know someone appreciates my skills. Gamora never could. Speaking of my dear sister, bet you got an earful. What'd she say about me? That I'm a waste of space? That I deserve everything I've been through?
Gamora says she still cares about you.
She sure has a funny way of showing it. Gamora doesn't even realize that she's the reason our family ended.
Yeah, but that's not how it looked to me.
What do you mean?
When we were in the temple, I saw Gamora's memory of your last mission.
Oh, yeah? What did you see?
I saw you stab her and leave her to die.
You have no idea what really happened that day. And neither does Gamora. Not all of it, at least.
Then show me.
Now, please take my hand.
If this kills me, I'm going to kick your ass. Is everything all right? What's going on?
I can't stand this place anymore. I can't stand him anymore.
Nebula? Come here. Nebula, my favorite daughter.
Father.
Your attacks against your sister were swift, precise. You disarmed Gamora easily. I was impressed.
Gamora is a good teacher. I owe all my knowledge to her.
And yet you emerged the victor. You have clearly outgrown her teachings. There is something you must know about Gamora. She has informed me that she does not want you around anymore. That she works better alone. Every day, she grows more agitated and bitter as she watches you surpass her. You've seen her lack of respect. She disobeys me time and time again. I no longer trust her. You shouldn't trust her either, Nebula. Gamora has become a risk to our family.
I know she's been difficult, but Gamora won't fail you, Father.
I caution you to be careful with your sister. That is all I ask. If she continues to be a problem, you might take her place. Stand by my side as my greatest warrior and only daughter. Gamora makes herself more useless, more unreliable with each passing day. Where she fails, you thrive.
It won't come to that, Father.
I'm not so certain. We shall see how things go on Phalion. This is your moment. Go and prepare. Keep your communications open. I'll be monitoring the situation.
Nebula, are you all right? Are you hurt?
Why? Why did you do that?
What?
I had him. That was my kill and you took it from me!
You distracted him. I killed him. We did this together.
But Father...
Thanos can complain about who did what all he wants. I don't care.
Nebula.
Father...
You were wrong. It has come to this after all. I am done with her insolence. If you don't get rid of her, I will do it myself. Only I will ensure that your sister suffers greatly.
Give me the device.
Nebula, what are you doing?
You took my kill. Give me the device in exchange. Give it to me! Now! I'm not asking here.
Fine. Here. Hey, it's going to be fine. We're going to be okay.
Wasn't over.
She showed me your last mission together.
I tried to show him what really happened with Tarval, but you interrupted us.
I'm sorry. I didn't know what was going on.
But you naturally assumed the worst.
What do you expect after everything that's happened?
Hey!
She was always pushing against Thanos, testing his limits. What happened was her fault.
Yeah. I practically shoved that knife into my own gut. Too bad I had such terrible aim. Some assassin.
Gamora, I wasn't trying to kill you.
Oh yeah? Then what were you doing?
Because it looked exactly like you were trying to kill me.
Thanos said if she didn't do it, he'd do it himself. Only he'd make you suffer.
It's true, Gamora. I saved your
Admit
life!
Admit it. You just wanted to prove you were better than me. By killing
if
me.
I wanted to kill you, you'd be dead! Thanos was going to kill you himself. There would have been nothing left of you. Do you know? I even checked your pulse, just to make sure you were still alive. You never got to see that part. The most important part. But I did.
That doesn't make any sense.
I'm kind of believing her here, Gamora. She hadn't fake killed you. I'm pretty sure Thanos would have been a lot more thorough.
It's possible. I don't know what to believe.
I'm just trying to keep us together. You're my family.
Oh, so you finally agree with me about something. What a surprise!
I'm just as surprised as you. I figured you'd disagree with me just because that's what you do.
Well, I'm not used to you saying anything I'd ever
Maybe
agree
you
with.
Just aren't listening.
If I'm not, there's probably a good
yeah,
reason.
And that reason is that you don't listen.
But logic is completely circular!
Guys! Stop! You both want the same thing!
He's actually right.
It happens, sometimes.
More than sometimes. Thank you.
Maybe we could give each other a chance?
All right.
Peter, I can finally sense the shrine.
Okay, let's go.
Well, it isn't my favorite assassin sisters.
Well, that'd be a pretty rad band name.
Hey, Peter. Give me one second. I'll meet you in my room.
Sure. Quill.
Thank you for talking to Nebula. It means a lot to have her here. It gives me hope.
What are you... Oh. Oh, we're doing this. Okay.
I do not usually hug.
Hey, Pete. I threw some mean words your way back there, and I wanted to apologize, you know. So, yeah. Sorry about that. I got worked up, you know? This whole Forge thing, it's kind of a lot for me to deal with.
Hey, don't even worry about it, man. Best friends forever?
Yeah, at least until death.
It's close enough.
Supreme joy! And also such sadness.
You are a very nostalgic person.
Hey, whoa, what's the matter? Why are you crying? Why am I crying? Oh, God!
The little box. It brings you so much sorrow. I'm sorry for that. Sometimes emotions overwhelm me and reflect back onto others.
That's cool. I'm cool. Okay.
Everyone on this ship is so poisoned by their feelings. Overly focused on the past. Not living here, in the now. Experiencing all the wonderful things around you.
But if we use the Forge, there are a few things about our past we can change.
That does not necessarily mean you should. You must have realized this by now, but if you bring someone back, it can never be as it was. Thank you for letting me listen to your music. It made me feel better and worse at the same time. I loved it.
Hey, Mantis. Can you direct me to that magic shrine thing now?
Of course. But it is a long way, and I must concentrate completely. There can be no distraction.
Awe-inspiring mess.
Distractions.
I'll see what I can do.
My pain with the rain in Shambhala.
mind in the halls of Shambhala.
Tell me why.
How does your light shine in the halls of Shambhala?
The entrance to the shrine. It.
Yay! Another temple!
The Kree were not only skilled warriors. You can find great symbolism in much of their architecture.
Yeah, they like pretty things. We get it. Now what, Pete?
Mantis? Any pointers?
It appears that the forge goes there, on the altar.
Seriously? Well, that was anticlimactic.
Much better.
It's not working.
Relic in place. Check. Must be something else to it.
Hey guys, have a look around. See if you can find anything that looks off.
I am Groot.
Of course something's wrong, because we're in a frickin' Kree temple, where everything is always more complicated than it needs to be. I mean, ain't they ever heard of an on switch?
Anything?
The forge led me here, but has grown quiet.
How do you know I'll make the right choice about the forge?
I do not know that.
Oh.
You are the wielder of the Eternity Forge. It chose you. You must trust there's a reason.
Yeah, okay. No pressure at all. So, what now?
Repair the statues. Determine the fate of the universe.
Oh, is that all? Well, we're about to seal the fate of the Eternity Forge.
Yes. Your decision will leave you despised by much of the team.
Good pep talk. Thanks, Drax.
No matter what you choose.
Yep, you can stop now. No matter what I decide about the Eternity Forge, you've got my back, right?
I am Groot.
Is that a yes? Or a no?
I am Groot.
How you holding up, buddy?
I am Groot.
Yeah, well, don't get your hopes up. Pete could still do the right thing and decide not to destroy the most useful artifact in the universe.
So, are you glad you stayed with Gamora?
Yes. I think staying close to my sister is what's best for both of us.
I hope so. Because otherwise I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get the blame. Once we get all these statues working, are you ready for whatever happens next?
That depends on you, Pete. You know how much bringing Lila back means to me. And only you can make that happen. There we go! Saying?
Hey, Rocket, tell Groot I need some help with the lens thingy.
Okay.
I am Groot.
Good job, buddy. That forge is gonna be resurrected in no time.
I am Groot.
He says you might destroy it. That he hopes you do.
Is that really what he said? One more to go. Something tells me it's not gonna be easy. How's it going, Gamora? In a few minutes, we're gonna have to decide the fate of the Eternity Forge.
Not we. You. For whatever reason, this is all in your hands. Look, I know you haven't really sided with me or taken any of my advice lately, but the Forge is dangerous. You have to make sure no one can use it. Ever.
Okay, let's see. This big guy used to stand here, holding up that giant whatever it is thingy. Then things go bad. Age sets in.
Oh no, I dropped it! Ah!
So where did it go? There it goes.
It is a hologram. You are so stupid.
Shut up. I knew that.
What now, Celestial One?
This thing really took a hit when that lens smashed into it.
It might still be intact under there.
That's what I'm counting on. Stupid jet boots overheated. Drax, I need your muscles.
You cannot have them. They are attached to me.
No, I know they... I need your help. I've got to lift something very heavy.
Ah, I see. You are weak. I will help you. I am ready.
Reach. Hey, Rocket. I need you to grab that lens.
Getting crushed to death ain't on my list of to-dos, Pete. I'm sure if you just reach really hard, you could get it. Maybe dislocated your shoulder or something?
I cannot fail.
Rocket!
You're the only one who can fit.
Ah, so it's a little guy thing, of course. Can't be that I'm the quickest or the
Rocket!
Smart. Okay. But I get smushed, I better be first in line for some resurrection.
Here.
Thanks.
Interesting.
Stop.
But there is still no statue upon which to set it.
I would have gotten the lens, guys. I was just, working up to it.
Yep. We just gotta, work together.
Oh, you mean like a team?
What a novel idea.
Yes, teamwork often brings good feelings.
Perhaps we are doing it wrong, then.
Okay, listen up. I need everyone over here.
Nope, not gonna happen.
Just a little higher!
My arms can't go any higher!
Your muscles are soft.
Shut up.
Guys, stop talking.
Like a baby's bottom.
Shut up.
Ow! That's my face!
A very fat baby.
Sorry. Hey, what do I know about... whatever you are, anatomy.
Idiots.
Maybe your people enjoy having their faces stepped on. Drop this thing!
No.
These freaking temples. I'm gonna take dynamite to all of them.
Now it is truly time to decide. Turn the forge to the left to destroy it forever. Turn the forge to the right to empower it and bring it to its full potential.
Okay.
Wait, his right or your right?
Oh.
I don't know.
What?
Let me see.
Wow. I can't believe that almost happened.
Turn it this way to destroy it. Turn it this...
Yeah, we got it. Turn it to the right, Pete.
It's left, Peter. You want your left.
Peter, you must turn it left.
No! It's right to empower you, idiot.
Oh, yes. Go right, Peter. I am Groot!
Destroying the Forge is the only way we can keep it from hurting people.
Don't listen to her. Think of your mom. Think of Lila.
I am Groot.
Shut up already! He's gonna use it!
I promise you my undying loyalty if you bring my family back to me.
Don't you see, Peter? Everyone wants this power, and no one should have it.
I'm sorry. But if the Forge can bring back the people we love, it's worth any risk.
As you wish, Celestial One.
We are no better than Thanos.
Don't bring your daddy issues into this.
Watch it, vermin!
Do not threaten my friend.
Pete did the right
thing. Says the raccoon who has no
moral compass
whatsoever.
Don't call me a raccoon! I'm looking out for Lila!
Process has begun. You can release it.
After you murder someone to bring her back!
Oh, you're gonna give me crap about murdering someone? You worried I'll take your place as the galaxy's number one murderer?
Rocket!
I am Groot! It is over. We won.
No, we just lost. How can neither of you see that?
Guys, we got company!
Thank you, Peter Quill. I never could have found this shrine without you. And the tracking device Jinsar placed on your ship.
You know, I didn't think you could get more annoying than that time you killed me. You really suck.
Their usefulness has expired. Dispose of them.
Oh, I've had about enough of this.
God, boots are more busted than I thought. How you like me now, huh? Huh? No!
Perish to the depths, blue demon!
He knows he can just let go, right?
Stop the rodent!
Big blue lady. Not the first time.
No!
intriguing.
Will you let me have a minute?
Sheesh. Now, where was I? Well, that was surprisingly easy.
Hang on, buddy, I gotcha!
Ah, crap.
I am Groot!
It's not like I did it on purpose. Things got a bit of a learning curve.
I am sorry to have made you sad.
We should do this more often. Looks like the boys could use some help.
This won't be easy.
Hope not.
So now Mantis is tagging along. but she's only creating more questions than answers. About the Eternity Forge, about Hala, about everything.
Janitors of the Galaxy, that's what we should be called. And Hala and the Kree, well, they're just the latest cosmic spill.
I am Groot. I am Groot.
Peter handed Hala everything that she wanted.
Well, it seemed like a good idea. It did.
It's what happened next that he should regret.